Inmost is a puzzle platformer by Chucklefish and Hidden Layer Games. I love Chucklefish. They made Wargroove. Oh, I can't wait to see what cheery, goofy game they made this time. This isn't cheery at all. In this game, you play three different characters. A man, a knight, and a little girl. Each character has their own purpose and gameplay. The man is more puzzle-based. You'll explore the world, solve the puzzles, and avoid monsters. The knight is more action-oriented. You fight the creatures and use your zip line to move around. And the girl is more story-based. You learn about the world and how everything ties together. The puzzles you encounter aren't the most difficult. There is very little backtracking you have to do, and you'll occasionally meet a character who will tell you exactly where you have to go. In fact, most everything you can interact with will flash a prompt. The only time I got stuck was when I had to find an item, but I never got a prompt when I passed it. So I thought it was some random background piece. This is also due to the color scheme, which is incredibly drab. Purposefully so, but at times it does make things hard to see. As the knight, you specifically fight monsters. There isn't too much to say about this. It's simple, does the job, not really hard either. Especially because there isn't a penalty for dying. If you die as the knight, you respawn and all the creatures you've killed stay dead. As the man, you can also find some collectibles. There are shards hidden around the world that are used to learn more about the story. And papers that have writings and drawings on them that also let you into the world's lore. Oh, this is going to get sad, isn't it? The story is the shining aspect of Inmost. I don't want to go into too much detail because of spoilers, but it feels like a bizarre, disjointed mystery that all ties together in the end. And it is depressing. That's a warning I feel like I should give. Inmost touches on some very serious issues. They do it tactfully, but still, the story is emotionally rough. Like, remember those shards I said you collect? You are told early on that those shards are literal pain. That all life carries pain. So as you play as the man and knight, you are going around collecting pain. Oh my god. My favorite detail is the subtle writing. As the girl, you can inspect your house. You'll get cute details about the home. Later, you get the same details with an extra line or two added in from the voice of her stuffed rabbit. And those lines add just enough information to make you question her home life or if she has something wrong with her. Or, you know, maybe she's just a creative kid, right? That's gotta be it, because I don't want to be sad. Technically, the game runs really well. I only had one moment where I thought the frame rate dropped significantly, though it is possible that was done on purpose for thematic reasons. I also want to shout out the sound design and music. In a game where dialogue is scarce, it is up to the other elements to step out, and the sound design flourishes. Whether it's a crashing of a plate or even near silence, there's always this level of dread looming. Inmost can take around 3 to 5 hours to beat and sells for $15. But do I recommend it? That's hard to say. I think a game like this depends on how you handle depressing home life stories. Inmost has been rattling in my head ever since I finished it, but if you already feel like you are trudging through an endless hallway with no direction, then maybe skip this game for a bit. But if you are ready to feel some genuine, gut-wrenching emotion, then Inmost is absolutely worth full price. Stupid Chucklefish. How can you have this logo and make this game? That's like if a company called Inevitable Death produced The Wiggles.